Welcome to another Noritake comparison video. This time we are going to focus on the concept of having an air gap between the touch panel and overlay and the performance difference between ITO and aluminum touch panels. Introducing an air gap into a design is often taken into consideration for keeping the display and protective overlay independent from each other, as this will reduce manufacturing and maintenance costs of the end product. In a similar fashion to our first comparison video, we will perform a few tests comparing our 7-inch GT-1P module with a competitor module with the same display and touch interfaces. Each test will use the same overlay material and thickness as the control, with a changing air gap as the variable. We will perform a 0, 1 millimeter, and 3 millimeter air gap test, along with a bonus test with a 3 millimeter air gap and leather gloves. Both of these modules use a PCAP touch panel. This technology uses a vast amount of transparent electrodes arranged in a specific pattern on two separate layers. In order to detect touch, the finger or conductor only needs to move near the screen into the electrical field present between the electrodes. If this field is reduced, a touch will be registered. The big difference between these modules is the material each product uses. The competitor uses indium tin oxide, and our MPCT touch screen uses aluminum. MPCT stands for metallized projective capacitive touch and implements a thin pitch aluminum mesh for the touch electrodes. The aluminum helps our touch panel yield a high signal to noise ratio, which grants high sensitivity in operation with an air gap and gloves. This is a constant factor within all of our MPCT touch panels. For the rest of this video, the product with ITO touch will be referred as a common touch screen, while the product with aluminum touch will be referred as an MPCT touchscreen. Now that you know the differences between these two technologies, let's test them out. With no air gap, the MPCT touch panel works just fine. With no air gap, the common touchscreen is very unreliable. With a 1 millimeter air gap, the MPCT touchscreen works just fine. The common touchscreen, however, is not getting any touch input whatsoever. With a 3 millimeter air gap, the MPCT touchscreen works just fine with a touch adjustment. And the common touchscreen is still having a very hard time getting any touch input. Now, gloved operation is another factor that sets MPCT apart from common touch. Since the electrical field picks up the incoming touch input, it can effectively look through the glove and still complete the circuit through the finger. Now let's see it in action. Now, even with gloves, the MPCT touchscreen works just fine. However, the common touchscreen is having an even more difficult time getting any sort of touch input. So, the different touchscreen materials are certainly apparent after performing these tests. The MPCT touch panel has a lot more flexibility when it comes to environmental variables compared to the common touch panel. Thanks for watching!